Hello, and welcome to this lecture video about machine learning on FPGAs. In this video, we have a look at the sigmoid function. I will tell you a little bit about the background and implementation on an FPGA and give you some exercises about it. In the neuron, you first calculate a value z, which is a factor times input values plus a bias. And this value z goes into the sigmoid function, which is depicted here. In the FPGA, we implement this function in a ROM. The ROM contains the values between plus minus 4, and values outside this range are limited. We have to consider that we have a fixed point implementation. And in an earlier video, we discussed the conversion from floating point to fixed point. The factors W have 5 binary places, so we shift by 5-bit, and the inputs x have 8-bit, so we shift for 8-bit. This makes a total of 13-bit, corresponding to 8192, so 8k. This means that the value plus minus 4 corresponds to a fixed point value of plus minus 32k. This is implemented in the VHDL code. The sum is limited to plus minus 4 and shifted to a positive range. Then we choose the word width of the ROM, and to limit the complexity, we do not use the complete 16-bit, but use 14-bit for the ROM. Other word widths can be chosen, so the design FPGA generate uses only 12-bit, and there we select different bits from the address. The ROM is implemented as an intellectual property, and the values for the ROM are defined in a so-called memory initialization file. You get the addresses on the left side and the output, the data, on the right side. The input values correspond to plus minus 4 as discussed, and the output values correspond to a range of 0 to 1 with 8-bit word widths. So we have a range of 0 to 255. This is the same accuracy as the input values x. If you have a different word width, also the MIF file is changed. And here you see the file for 12-bit. We have a different depth of the ROM, and also the data is different. And basically, the 12-bit input values correspond to the 14-bit values divided by 4. So instead of 8,000, we have divided by 4 the value of 2,000. Now we come to the exercises that you can do with the sigmoid function. First thing is that you can implement the ROMs with different input word widths. And we provide MIF files for 12, 13, 14, 16-bit. You can use them, or you can generate other word with 8, 9, 10, 11-bit, what you think is appropriate, and then compare FPGA resources, power consumption, and also the quality of the color detection. You can also check that if you make the ROM size smaller than the FPGA modules, you don't save resources. In the code that I've shown you on the previous slide, we change the IP core, but it would be easier to select the word width of the ROM with a generic parameter. And you can do this with the VHDL command if generate. Have a look at the syntax in the literature. Or you can change the ROM to a case statement. For verification, you should check the functionality and the resources uses for different word width. It would be the best approach to choose the parameter at the top level and forward the generic parameter to the neuron and the sigmoid function. If you have a larger word width, the ROM require a lot of resources. So it would be a good idea to save resources, and you can do this by using a ROM with two ports. The FPGA RAMs have two ports. All ROMs have identical content, so you can implement two sigmoid functions in one ROM. And this requires a new submodule that contains two neurons, so there are some changes that you have to make. Another way to save memory on the FPGA is considering that the output processing does not require the sigmoid function. So in the design FPGA plane, the output processing only checks if the value is larger than 127 or not. So therefore, you don't need the complex sigmoid function before checking this value. The same holds for the design FPGA generate. You check if the value is larger than 127, And you also compare which one of the values of the different colors, in our example, yellow and blue, is larger. So therefore, the output layer can use a simplified function by just forwarding the top 8 bits of the address. And to make it easy to handle, you could select this simplification by a generic value to the neuron. So the neuron gets an information, does it belong to the output layer, true or false. There is another video with more exercises about other topics for machine learning on FPGAs. So maybe you also want to have a look at that video. Thanks for watching.